Hello, everyone, and welcome to this week's STEM Challenge. This week is all about folk tales, myths, and legends. So this week, what I want you to do is to create your own labyrinth. Now, a labyrinth, if you don't know, is a maze, but it's not just a regular maze where you walk on through and it's lovely. There are obstacles. There might be creatures. It might not be the easiest thing to get through. So in your design, you want to think of several different things for your maze. First of all, what surface are you working on? Do you have an area that you wanted to stay on in your home and you're just going to build on top of it? Or do you want to make it be able to move and take it somewhere else? If you're using Legos, you might want to use one of their flat surfaces to start with and then build on top. Or you might want to use the side of a box as your surface if you have a large one. Or if you want to keep it somewhere, use a table and build on top of the table. Once you have your surface, you now need to think about what's the purpose of the maze. Obviously, you want to get through the maze, but why? What's at the other side? Are there jewels or is there something exciting? Is it saving someone? Is it getting out alive? What is your goal of getting through the maze? Once you have that, now think about what is going to be in the maze. Is this a maze where there are trees lining the whole path, kind of like Harry Potter? Or are there walls? You can use the side of a box to make a wall. It also depends on the height of what of your items that are walking through. Do you have little creatures that you've been playing with, or G.I. Joes, or some other kind of action figure that you want to be going through your maze? That is the height that you want to keep in mind, because in a maze, the wall should be taller than whatever the character is. So in your design, keep that in mind. Once you have the characters that are going to be in it going through the maze, the idea of kind of how high they're going to be and that flat surface, your next thing is really to think about what are the obstacles in mind. Now, this is probably going to depend on who it is. If you have a certain action figure or a superhero or somebody from Greek mythology, you might want to use different types of obstacles, right? So you might want to have other characters, other creatures in there that are positioned in a certain place and will do something when they come across them. Or you might want to have situations where the walls are blocked off. You can't get through this way. You'll have to go all the way around and back. You might also want to have something where something happens to the character when they get to that point. Maybe there's something on top of the wall that will fall down and hit them. It's up to you. There's a lot of options here. But think about it from above. You are looking into the maze. What do you want to happen as somebody gets through the maze? There might also be something that's distracting to them that they really like, and then they won't get through the maze, so they have to figure out how to stop being distracted. Once you've built your whole maze, which should be a time-consuming process, practice going through the maze. You are the character. Act it out. What will happen? What stops them? Can they get through it? Is it too easy? It's too easy. You need more obstacles. Maybe have a friend or a family member go through it as that character and have them test it out for you to make it better and better each time. Should tell a story. That's the idea here. Once you're done, I would love to see what you create. So if you are doing the summer reading program this year, it is all online through ReadSquared. On there, if you go to mission number 2, you will see this description for this particular activity. And there's a place where you can upload a picture of what you've done, or you can write a description of what you've done. You'll get points for the summer reading program. So I would love to see what you create. Have fun. Don't make it too easy.